Hello! Welcome back to Let's Play Escape from Monkey Island. This is episode 2, and this is Rocket Baby Dolls. So in the last episode we had a round of insult arm wrestling, which was fairly straightforward. For now, we need to stop this maniac from destroying the mansion. So we need a snack. And the only guy who's got it is this guy here.
I guess he doesn't want anyone taking his birthday pretzels. It says, happy birthday. No, it's probably the only thing this poor guy has to his name. Hi there, fellow swashbuckler. What's the word on the street?
Ballsack!
Got any more juicy nuggets of info?
Where?
How would you like to join my crew on a dangerous piratey mission?
Oh, yeah.
We'll be searching the seven seas for sunken treasure.
You can't.
I'll take that as a no, then. What's that you're drinking?
Blue-blue-zee-zoo.
Say, mind if I have some of your pretzels?
You can't.
You look like a busy man. I'll let you get back to your self-destructive binge drinking.
The reason why we asked these pirates to throw darts at everything.
Ahoy again, mateys! Excuse me. Hey! I bet you can't hit another one on the first shot.
Name it and I'll eat it.
Because further down on the list is the option to hit the balloon.
I bet you can't hit that balloon over there.
No problem.
Hey, you're pretty good. Well, I guess I'll be shoving off now.
Are you still here?
I guess he won't be needing these anymore.
On the advice of... I can't remember the person in the forum, but I have changed the camera angle settings. So... actually, let's go back to the mansion, then we'll explore the island some more.
Let's try...
Excuse me.
Yeah, just a sec.
22?
5.5. Minus 27.
What?
Usually, in the previous games, there'd be an automatic... or there'd be an option on there.
You seem like a busy man. I'll let you return to your evil deeds.
Thanks.
Well, I just remember there's one thing I need to do first. Oh, this is the
As useful as a two-pronged cactus would be, I'd rather not stick one in my pants.
Okay. I don't even have it. And in this game, thankfully, there is a quick exit option. So, let's go and see Meat Huck.
Meat Hook's House of Wax. It's locked. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Anybody home?
No. Go away.
But there's supposed to be a wax show today.
No, there isn't.
Yes, there is.
No, there isn't.
The sign out here says there is.
Yeah, that. Well, it's cancelled.
It's okay. It's me.
Me who?
Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate.
Nice try. Guybrush and Elaine are dead. I know why you're here, and you can't have it.
What are you talking about?
Stop pretending, you greedy old man. You think you can just buy up the whole island just because you can insult people? Well, think again. You can't take my house away from me if you can't get in. I knew I shouldn't have fixed that bridge.
Then who are you?
No one. There's no one here.
When do you expect someone to be home?
Later. Much later. Finish running your wife's errands first. There's nobody home. Now go away.
Okay, I'll come back later.
Okay, so if he thinks I'm the Australian guy, then why did he tell me to finish my wife's errands? Anyway, let's see about chartering a ship. And the harbour has moved.
This inner tube looks as though it's been subjected to unspeakable stresses. I sure could go for a nice, refreshing grog right now. I can't use this machine. I don't have any money.
This is what I was needing.
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, and I need a ship.
How nice for you. And just what do you want me to do about it?
Are you the harbor master?
No, I am the harbor mistress. My full title is Chief Assistant Shipyard Regulator, Harbor Operations, Malay Island, a division of Inter-Island Transportation Services.
Which means?
Which means I'm in charge of ship allocations on Malay Island.
Baby, you can be in charge of my ships any day of the week.
What? Are you trying to seduce a government employee?
No. So, you're in charge of the ships? Kinda snooty for a glorified barnacle watcher, aren't you?
You're just jealous of my cushy government job. It would be even better if I didn't have to put up with the likes of you.
I'm commandeering a vessel.
Not so fast, mister. No boat leaves this harbor without my permission, and I see no reason to give you permission to take one of my boats.
But Stan said I could.
Name dropping won't get you a boat.
I'm married to the governor.
I heard she was dead.
Well, she does have her quiet moments, but she's alive and back on Malay and ready to govern.
Oh, so she's just been on vacation all this time, huh? That's nice. She won't be governor for long. I'm voting for Mr. Charles. He promised me a promotion.
Come on, just give me a boat.
The rules prohibit the shipyard regulator, that would be me, from lending a boat to anyone who does not have proper authority. That would be you.
What would it take to get you to look the other way?
I really hope that you aren't trying to bribe an employee of the Malay Island government. Not that I care what happens to you, but I really don't want to fill out the paperwork.
Isn't there some sort of loophole?
Nope. It's simple. Prove to me that you have the authority to requisition a ship, and I will follow procedure to supply one.
Come on. Just this once? For me!
Not for you or anyone. Rules were meant to be followed. Just prove to me that you have the authority to requisition a ship, and I will follow procedure to supply one.
Never mind.
Now that I can do.
Say, haven't I seen you somewhere before?
But I'm sure I don't know what you're talking about.
I know. At the scum bar! You're the naked girl in the painting!
I am not! Besides, I haven't taken my clothes off in years.
Who painted you?
He was an awful man. He was good, but he wouldn't take his claws off me. Strange, too. He had a bizarre fascination with wax.
Meat Hook. So Meat Hook is the artist.
You could lose your job if anyone found out that you posed for that picture.
How do you think I got my last promotion?
I'd rather not think about it. What's your name?
Why?
Well, I'd like to know the names of the people I've seen naked.
I wasn't naked. I was artistically posed.
You must be some kind of ship expert to land such an important and specialized job.
Nope. Don't know anything about them, and I can't stand sailing. I'm just paying my dues until I get a supervisor's job.
All this red tape is giving me a headache.
Don't say I didn't give you anything.
Right. Now to stop the catapult. Go on.
Let's try 49, 7.9, minus 11. Fire!
Ooh, Not a bad piece of modern art, if I do say so myself.
Hey! Get away from there! Before I pop you one on the head, capiche? Good! Now stay over there, pencil neck!
Hey there, here, I brought you some kudu jerky pretzels.
Really? Thanks. I really appreciate this.
You're welcome. You know, you could thank me by not chucking big old boulders at my house.
I could, but I won't. Now leave me alone for a minute while I eat these.
Oh, ungrateful.
So, we need to fiddle with his catapult so he realigns it. Like so.
Hey, what do you think you're doing?
Nothing. I don't know what you're talking about.
You totally messed up my catapult. What you trying to do to me? You're killing me over here. Well, guess I'm gonna have to start over at my calibration cactus over there. Get out of my way.
I hope this works.
Oh, God.
There. It's recalibrated to the cactus. Let's try it. Fire! What the? Yeah! Ha! I can't believe you did that!
Guess what? I'm still dead.
Don't worry. I'll love you even after rigor mortis sets in.
We've been gone so long, they didn't think I was coming back. So those numbskulls at City Hall declared me dead at sea.
What about me? Did they say anything about me?
No. Then they decided to sell all my belongings and destroy the mansion.
That's terrible. Did they sell any of my stuff?
And the worst part is, they've ordered a new election for the office of governor.
Maybe I should run.
So far, there's only one candidate. And you know the old slogan, when there's only one candidate, there's only one
choice.
Who are you?
The name, Mr. Threepwood, is Charles L. Charles. But you can call me the next governor of Melee Island.
You can't be the governor. I'm the governor. And it's a lifetime term.
Well, that's the rub, isn't it? You've been declared dead.
So I've heard. How did that happen?
Who can say? Perhaps if you'd spent a little more time governing and less time gallivanting all over the Tri-Island area with your pet monkey, the good citizens of Melee wouldn't have come to the mistaken conclusion that you were pushing up the petunias.
Wait a second. Was I the pet monkey in that last sentence?
Okay, we get it. You're running for governor. But why destroy my mansion?
Oh, that. When you died, the mansion became the property of the state. As a favor to me, the future governor of Melee Island, the town elders contracted a demolition firm.
That's me.
To destroy this outdated bourgeois symbol of the elitist piratocracy.
But why?
Because the days of pirate princesses ruling from secluded mansions are over, my friend.
They are?
Indeed they are, lad. If the Melee Island of tomorrow is to prosper, it must be governed by a man of the people. A man unafraid to mingle with the common folk. A man who won't hide in a mansion guarded by vicious piranha poodles.
A man like you?
Precisely.
He makes a lot of sense, Elaine. I never did like those poodles.
Guybrush!
Well, I've got hands to kiss and babies to shake. Ta!
There's something fishy about that guy.
Really? I thought he smelled more like a rotting corpse.
I've got another plan.
With maybe a hint of oregano.
Guybrush!
Woohoo! How can I help?
Go to Lucre Island to talk to the family lawyers.
But why? I destroyed the catapult.
Yes, dearest, I know. But with that demolition order hanging over the mansion, another catapult could come at any moment. We need the kind of restraining order that only my family lawyers can provide.
But I want to come up with clever campaign slogans and do ops research.
Guybrush, love of my life, I'm a politician. Let me do what I do best. I'll let you do what you do best.
What's that?
Sailing around the Tri-Island area on seemingly pointless errands.
What?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I say that out loud? What I meant to say was venturing into troubled waters on dangerous quests.
Well, okay then. That's more like it.
Okay. I'm off to start my campaign. Don't spend too much time on Lucre Island, dearest.
Wait a second. At the end of Curse, wasn't Elaine the governor of Pure Topolo? And at the... they got married at the end. So this is taken... this is after their wedding and their honeymoon. And what's she doing on Melly Island? No wonder they've declared her dead.
We don't own many coats in these tropical climes. How could a mere painting capture the essence of my love?
Oh, that's so sweet, Guybrush. Now get back to work.
Yes, dear. It's an old sofa. No, that sofa doesn't have enough lower back support. Wouldn't want to end up becoming a hunchback and looking abnormal. Wow, this plant is really resilient. We haven't watered it since we left. Hey, it's Elaine as a little kid with Grandpa Marley. Oh, how cute.
Don't make me get out your baby pictures.
But honey, you don't have any of my baby pictures.
No, but I have some of you crying after you got smacked in the head. What's this for?
I'm not sure. I just have a hunch that a signed government contract might be useful.
All right, let me sign it. I already signed this.
Oh, yeah.
Let's explore a little bit before we talk to Elaine. Not that there's much to explore, really.
It's the door to our bedroom. Oh, yeah. I like this kind of commode better than the one in the bathroom. The one made of... porcelain. I'm no expert, but this china doesn't seem very nice. It's a government paper of some sort. The header says, Melee Government Employment Contract. Cushy edition.
Aha, that's where it is.
Another contract?
Just to be safe.
Well, so much for my status as a reform candidate. All right, let me sign it.
The significance of that will become more apparent a bit later on.
Groovy Banner. For some reason, it makes me want to ride a hog. I love chess. Especially the horsies. I've got no time for easily mastered games like chess. Hello, Governor.
What are you doing here, Guybrush?
What was I supposed to be doing?
Have you been drinking grog again?
Maybe a little. Is that so wrong?
There's a time and a place for everything, Guybrush. Now pay attention. Now, while I concentrate on running for re-election, you're going to get yourself to Lucre Island. And once there, you will visit with the Marley family lawyers. And you'll work with them to find a legal way of saving the mansion from Charles's demolition goon. Got it?
Did you see the way I rid us of that cataclysmic catapult?
I always knew you had it in you to destroy heavy machinery, my chaotic little pet. Unfortunately, that's only a stopgap measure. We have to find a more permanent solution.
We could move away and leave this mess for someone else.
But I like living here. Besides, it's probably just as messed up everywhere else.
We can make a public offering of the island and retire on the proceeds.
You mean like Melee.com? That's stealing. Even for pirates.
We could launch a full-scale attack on City Hall. Hold the town hostage, I say. Arr!
That's not very civilized, Honey Bear. Besides, I wouldn't want you to get hurt. I'm too young to be a widow. Thanks for trying to help, Guybrush, but I think we need to stick to the current plan.
I'll get right on it. I'm having a little trouble getting a ship.
What kind of trouble?
I don't have the authority to requisition one. Can you believe that? Me! There must be a bunch of new people around here since we left.
Here, take this. It should give you an air of authority.
What's this doohickey?
It's the official gubernatorial symbol of Melee Island. It conveys the authority of the Office of Governor. It also gets the holder into some pretty great parties.
A true pirate doesn't need some gubernatorial symbol to prove he commands respect.
Yes, well, all the same, I think you'd better take it.
All right. Oh, does this mean I get to run the island now? I've got some revolutionary ideas about subsidized childcare.
Just give it back the minute you return from Lucre Island.
Can I have some money?
Why?
I'm not sure, but it always seems as though I could use a few hundred pieces of eight on my adventures.
Well, I'd like to help, sweetheart, but we're kind of strapped for cash right now. Besides, what happened to your monthly allowance?
I blew it all gambling on spitting contests on Booty Island.
Well, then I'm sorry, my dear. It's time you learned an important lesson about budgeting.
Oh, shucks. Nobody wants to be on my crew.
Ask nice and don't make any ridiculous promises.
Hey, you should use that in your campaign.
I'll leave the crew selection to you, my dearest, and you can leave the campaign management to me. Is there anything else?
I'll let you concentrate on your campaign.
Thanks.
Right. Let's go get this crew. If I can get around this map. Right. Ah, you bastard. Take two. Right, on the table was the more obvious contract, which if you offer it to them.
Wow. You actually got us a signed government contract?
Hmm. Looks good. Very nice.
Wait a minute. This is a standard government manual labor contract with no pension plan or dental coverage.
Hey, you're right. We want a cushy government contract with a desk.
Come back when you got something that doesn't involve back-breaking labor.
So, the less obvious one.
Wow. You actually got us a signed contract. Well, let's see. Mm-hmm. Yes. Ah, yes. Good. Aha!
Carla, do you even know what half of this stuff means?
Not a clue. But look, it says cushy in the title.
Wait. All right, then.
All right, Threepwood. You've got yourself a crew.
And let's get this ship, which I believe might be the last part of.
Hi, I'm back. Nice night for a sail, huh?
It would be if you had a boat.
All this red tape is giving me a headache.
Don't say I didn't.
No, I forgot. You have to put everything in your hands.
I need a ship.
I told you, you don't have the authority to...
Check this out.
What's this?
The gubernatorial seal of Melee Island.
Oh, I see. Mm-hmm. Well, I guess you are an important person. Right this way, Mrs. Marley. Let me show you to your ship.
Thank you.
This is the dainty lady.
It's pink.
You've obviously got a seaman's eye for nautical details.
But it's pink.
Now, there are a couple of regulations that I'm required to explain to you. First, bring it back in the same or better condition as it is now. Second, life preservers are to be worn by all crew and passengers at all times. Finally, this vehicle is to be used for official business only, so no joyriding.
Can I go now?
Well, I'd love to hang out here on the docks with you all day. Actually, that's a lie. I can't stand to be near you. Bye. Oh, and enjoy your voyages on the Dainty Lady.
It's pink.
Is that the ship?
It doesn't look very seaworthy.
At least it doesn't smell like monkeys.
Are you guys ready to go?
Aye, Captain.
Whatever.
No.
Don't make me slap you, Otis.
Fine. Let's get this over with.
Then we're off to Lucre Island in search of high adventure and a legally binding restraining order.
It'll all end in tears. Mark my words.
Mr. Cheese, shouldn't we steer away from those dark, portentous clouds?
Nonsense, Captain. A little rain never hurt anyone.
Wow!
Mommy!
Button down the
hatches! Running.
Short and sail!
Clear the scuppers!
Drain the bilges!
Get your hands off me!
Sorry, baby.
There you go, Mr. Marley. Lucre Island.
Ah, Lucre Town. The largest urban center in the Tri-Island area. Thanks, Mr. Cheese. Next time, you think we can get here with a little less drama?
Oh, no. There's not going to be a next time, is there?
Better not be. Once was enough.
Okay, I'm going into town. You guys stay here and watch the ship.
Oh, sure. I see how it is. The captain gets to make all the decisions.
Right. Now we have reached Lucre Island. I think this is a good time to stop this episode. It's almost time anyway. But yes, here we are. Thank you for watching. I will see you again for the next episode. Take care. Bye-bye.